Ooh, good morning, good evening, good afternoon, good night. My geek Ronin grunts, my geek samurai army, you geek elite gamers, you and Dragons of the Black Gaming Guild, established 1976, proud to support and sponsor, be partnered with, and work on hard ass shit with many amazing gamers and streamers, but none more so than Stardust Samurai, your great sage, your satyr host with the most. Today, your stellar Sherpa. Today, we're breaking the Vault of Glass, and I need two hard ass motherfuckers, level 25. And above, who want to come and do it with me. Now we're looking for people to, where is my camera driver? There it is. Got a nice yellow hue in the house today. What is everyone up to? Alright, looks like Van Bane and Easy might be the ones to go with us to the Vault of Glass. Patch might be out today, people. Around 6. So. We're going to leave that up for right now while we get ready. How's everyone doing today? He's playing Strike. Maybe I should do a little warm up here for like 20-30 minutes and then go do the Vault of Glass. Don't forget, people, you can head over to JamieWorm1 on YouTube and JamieWorm1 on Twitch. And you can see some of his co-exploits with yours truly, Stardust Samurai, the Stellar Sherpa, your Great Sage, your Satyr host with the most here on Destiny, as well as other games that we play with Jamie. pretty much, you know, I hands down want to say Geekly Gaming approved, and hopefully I'll hop on to Geekly Gaming Streaming Guild. I was going to reshave my mohawk today, but I didn't want to do it this morning. It's an extra like 15-20 minutes and then a really good shower to get all that loose hair off. I didn't want to deal with that today. After the show, I always take another shower, you know, kind of like a take two. Because when I get off the show, I just start an 8-hour shift in the art studio, music studio, parenting department, boyfriend department, cook, cleaning, maid. Try to get some PR and stuff put out for the show and good things like that. Speaking of which, let me go in here really quick. I want to post this over here. Copy. Paste. I want to give big thanks out to all the new followers yesterday. We had over 20 followers yesterday. It was one of our best days in quite some time. Now, a lot of that has to do with Minecraft. Nothing wrong with that. I'm all good with Minecraft. But it is interesting how that game just draws it in. Now, yesterday, a lot of people came in, and a lot of people, you know, were playing with us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And threw out friend requests. It was a private server. Today, or next time we play Minecraft, when I'm doing it, just come back into the show and say, "Hey, this is my friend handle. Friend me up," and I'll go ahead and get to it. So I made this last night, just dinking around in the studio, digital studio. It's actually a hand-painted one that I negatived and then I threw some text and font on. It's nothing big. It took me like 5 minutes. This isn't fancy or shit. But working on some new backdrops for the PlayStation as well as other things. And we threw that out. We'll be basically getting this onto our PS3 and we'll be sending it out over to PlayStation. Look for a little special Geekly Gaming Guild to be popping up in PlayStation Home again as well. And DC Universe, bringing it back. We also have Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic on PC. We have so many games that we have s too many games that we can't play here on the show. So, you know, we're more than just GTA, Minecraft, Destiny. Now, on the PlayStation 3, we're of course showing mad love to the PlayStation 3 because it's not dead yet. We got PS4, kick that shit in like December, January next year. When I see like, you know, but the PS3 is still a viable game system that kicks ass. It, literally like overnight, it became, there was something new and something better and it became shit. And, you know, there's still a lot of people viewing it, play it, and a lot of people that want to play with streamers and be part of streaming guilds and be part of the growing Twitch and all that jazz. But they're like, I'm not on the PS4, PC, or Xbox One. I have a PS3, like a majority of gamers in the world, and you know, like we talked about many times over Christmas, second generation, thinner, stronger, cheaper. We'll see a majority start to tick over to PS4, and in probably 2 years' time, it'll be 75% of PS players are on the PS4, and 80% of gamers in the world are on the PS4, and so like that. But we're still showing some mad love for the PS3. Easy. Should get on with me. All right. So let's see who's on now. We got Hip Checker. All right. I'll send Easy an invite and Vane Bane. Hip Checker, I believe you're a friend of a friend. You're not on my friends or not on the show, so I'm gonna try to get you into the guild. People, once again, right now it's all whatever, but down the road, probably a month from now, 2 months from now, if it doesn't say Dragons of the Black under your name up there, just like with other ones, you're probably not gonna make it in. Oh, he's not watching the show. Now what I'll do is I'll wait here for a few moments because I don't even know if like, oh, Easy can do the vault. That's right, he's done it before. Accessory, Bluetooth, accessory down three. I've memorized like. All right, Easy. Hold on 1 second. I'm just getting my mic set up. All right, we're doing the Vault of Glass, babies. The Vault of Glass. I hope people got some time to dig in. Now, we're going to wait here for Vane Bane to jump in for a few moments. And then before we go, I will set... Hold on one second. I will set it up so I can invite the other people that are online. We'll try to get them in. He sent me a subject thing, but there's no mail.
I kind of wish I could trade some of my old ships in for Glimmer.
Alright, so I talked to... Now, this is not verified by Bungie people or Activision by any resource, but I tapped Spit33, Kai, our alpha tester on PS4, our beta tester on PS4, the man who gives us all the inside details. Rumor, word, 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, my time, the patch might drop by. So... Right now, people, if you get a rare engram or a legendary, just put it in your vault. That's it. If it's uncommon green, just go ahead and do it. Another interesting thing was, is he was talking to me in some forums, and I linked over and went over the loot system, the way it works. The farming caves weren't even really lootable for like that, because it only drops a legendary about every like 1,000 to 2,000 drop kills. And it only drops an uncommon like every 250 to 750. That's a huge gap there for a reason, because it's not, you know, after you, so think about that. You know, you kill somebody, you see a blue, you're most likely not going to see another blue to kill a couple hundred more. Now, that was just speculated number theory, that those numbers could be completely different. But that's how the system kind of works. It's not saying the 250 is the start point. It's just saying that it's a minimum and maximum, and then after it goes past that, it goes into the legendary category. And there's still always a chance nothing will drop and push you into the better category. Well, anyways, so if and things were leveled by the creature that you fight, or sorry, were leveled by you, not the creature you fight. So the loot case had some potential and some not. But then the higher level also had a better chance. So people that were fighting like we were, mid and higher, were probably more likely to find good gear than the people that would sit there for hours and hours. It was an interesting take about it, but I guess apparently what I was doing, I didn't even know it, because of course people know I don't watch a lot of YouTube, and I'm always on here. But apparently what me and Easy and what I was doing on the show that day was called farm busting and break dancing, when somebody goes and dances.